What's up? I hope everything's working sound-wise. Good lord, it better be working properly, because I tried so hard. Although I still can't get, I think I can't get game sound to come through. So luckily I don't play a lot of games that have, like, voice acting that you really need to hear, and we can just turn the game music off and play our own music kind of thing. Ooh. Yeah! Look at his hair. It's all short! It's so short! I love it. It's, a godsend. I don't know why people still have long hair. It's fucking the worst. Like, once I vacuum up all the loose hairs, which will take me probably the next year, it's gonna be amazing. I hate dealing with hair. From the other ones you've seen. Alright. Also, I hope I don't lurk too hard later, because I might be playing a game that has, chat, interaction. I've got Death and Taxes. Oop, I opened the wrong thing. I've got Death and Taxes that uses chat stuff. And then I've also got, The Wandering Village. And I feel like I have another one that has chat commands. Either way, we're starting with RimWorld, though. So, yeah, lurk, because it's going to be probably kind of boring, but it's just going to be chill music, playing some RimWorld. I'm going to start a colony that will be the stream colony. Oh, Lord. It's been a long time since I've had, like, bangs, even. So, like... Also, I know that I'm getting better, even though I feel sometimes like I'm not getting mentally better, because I have, like, new hair growing. And that was, like, before I got my hair cut, and it was all short. But, like, I could see it, like, out of the corner of my eye all the time, and I'm always like... But I know, because I, through stress, developed, like, receding bald spots, and they're growing in again, and I'm so excited. Oh. Be an actress where I sit it. Alright. Let's start some gameage. And I have it set to technically play the game sound, but, hey now. No, you're not supposed to be playing anything, because you're not supposed to have... Nope, that's the wrong. Sorry, I gotta fuck around for a minute. How long I've been waiting for death. Ah, that's what I thought. It's supposed to be that. And that plays no sound for no reason. That's okay. We'll see if it actually works. I also forgot to pull this down. Sorry, one sec. Uno momento. Okay. Now everything should be set. Knows how long I've been waiting. How long I've been... So I've already done Crash Landed. Well, I'm kind of doing that, like, on my own to learn. But I kind of want to try out something different. But I also... I don't want to, like, try something that's going to be, like, too hard. I can play it on easy mode, I guess. Yeah, let's do Lost Tribe. We're a lost tribe, a tribesman. Okay. Oh God, your tribe was destroyed by the great blood machines sent by the gods. This is a very different start. The other one is like your spaceship crash lands. Hold up. Oh. I can turn it down on my ears. I forgot. As the year without a summer. The rich explorer. No, we're not gonna do that one. Hey, my lord! I'm trying to decide what to start with, because I've already done Crash Landed. So Mary Shelley had to stay inside and she wrote Frank. So I know how to start that one. Random pets time three. This one only has one. It's a tough call. I don't want it to be too hard, because I don't want to have to start over a million times, because I do that, because I'm a perfectionist. I'll still start over a million times. Watch me. Alright, we're gonna try, we're gonna try Lost Tribe. Hopefully. Stay with Cassandra Classic. Yeah, we'll do not the super easiest deck. Reload anytime, because I'm gonna do that a lot. Alright. I'm gonna take out the pirate gangs just to make it a little easier, and the savage tribe will keep the rest. Koala is a good seed, I guess. Let's generate! Woo! Benjamin Franklin and his experiments with electricity! Alright. Let's try the good scorpion reach. Can I go there? Oh my god, of course not. Growing period. Never! Alright. Now, I've been playing in temperate forests. And those work pretty good. Is there. You know what? It's fine. That's how it formed. I'm not gonna judge it. Ooh, should I go island? I'm trying to think, like, if there's. I haven't played for long enough to know that, if claiming an island is gonna screw myself over or not. Because I'm like, wait, it gives you quests to go places, but I don't think I can travel across water. So that's. Let's plop ourselves up here somewhere, near the Jaum Ocean. Maybe, can I just go into the ocean? Right into it. Where's, I like having a river. There's a good river spot. Alright. We're kind of away from everybody. Alright. Oh yeah, we get to pick people. I forgot. Okay. Oh lord. Okay. So we've got. In the other game I play, that would be way too much to give people right off the bat, but these, I don't know, in this game, everybody works faster, it seems. Or are at least more capable of doing things. Y'all got all your stuff? Alright, let's, hunt some animal. Alright. So we need a butcher spot. Crafting spot. Go in here and you have to set it. Oh no, this is due forever because you just want to butcher anything you have. But I want a decent amount of kibble. That's just what you feed everything. And we have enough weapons. Options because I'm a different thing now. I'm not the new arrival of the tribe. That's well, cool. I didn't have the war mask or the tribal Reverend, head dress.
Reverend, please come quick.
There.
I got something to admit.
Now. Starting.
I met a man out in the sticks.
I know how my other people liked it, but they were not these people, so.
It's over series tank, Cadillac, and more cigar on his lip.
I'm gonna do standalone buildings for this one.
Don't you know the devil?
Normally.
Where's a suit and tie? So I'm driving down the 60.
I would have everybody in one big connected building, like a house with a bunch of separate bedrooms. But I'm gonna try having everybody get their like own individual house and have like a different building for like the crafting, or, you know what I mean? I mean, right now, I'm actually just going to throw everybody into the same building.
But
where's the bed? Bedroll is... I don't have cloth, though. Oh,
I know
this is different.
You by the state of your hands.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You're a six-string picker, just as I
am. For now.
I am. Let me learn you some, I know if you turns to make all the girls dance. Don't you know the devil?
Oh, good.
Where's the suit and tie? So I'm driving down to 61 in early July.
Schedule.
White as a cotton field and sharp as a knife. I heard them howling
as they passed me by. Recreation in the morning. And evening. Forced recreation. Work block.
Foolish was I.
Ah! I need to.
Damn my foolish eyes.
Fuel stove. I can actually cook
that man's
things out of the meat that I get from that.
Had a price. Oh,
oh
sweet,
sweet
price. My sweet soul,
everlasting,
my very own eternal
light. I don't have my pigeon on that screen. I got it. They don't have dual monitor support for him yet from a baby. Thank you. I forgot Twitter existed again.
Driving down the 61 in early July. Wide as a cotton field and sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me by.
Why? Don't make me do things.
I saw him driving down the 61 in early July. Wide as a cotton field and sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me.
Just looked at your pinned tweet. I love Finn. Bam. Hope that worked. Bum ba dum bum 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 bum. I hope that I'm your remaining friends. Why is there no wall there? And there's no wall even being built there. Is that me? Did I do that? Forgave us. I hope the fences we mended fall down beneath their own weight. it. I hope it's already too late.
I hope the junkyard a few blocks from
here. No, I need someday burns down. What's this? Steel door. Deconstruct some of this shit. We need some steel, baby. Steel walls. Nice! Oh, yeah, we'll get there. We'll get there. You guys just gotta deconstruct. Okay. So this is how they work the schedule. Well, not the schedule, but when people are doing stuff. You do this. But it goes like left to right, and they just go through and do things in the right order. And it just... I haven't quite figured out how to optimize it properly yet. I mean, there's, you know, the obvious part.
I hope I cut myself shaving tomorrow. I hope it bleeds all day long. Our friends say it's darkest before the sun rises. We're pretty sure they're all wrong. I hope it stays dark forever.
Oh, and I need a pen.
The worst is it over.
I hope you blink before I do. I hope I never get sober. And I hope that you think of me years down the line. You can't find one good thing to say.
And I'd hope that if I found the strength to walk out, you'd
stay the hell out of my way. I am drowning.
There is no sign of land. You are
tedious part. Everybody, if they just do these jobs as soon as they come up, they don't come up very badly. Okay. Now you are a Smith Taylor crafter, so. Now, you should then also be one of the builders. And I like to make it so that, like, they'll still do the things if it's, like, the only thing to do, whereas if you leave it blank, they won't do it even then. But you know, if you got nothing else to fucking do, do it. So this one is cook and hunt. That should be about good. I'm gonna make this one my... No, yeah. I guess it's the only one that can really be my, farmer. Oh my god, I can't even brain today. Actually, maybe no, because he's already a miner. Hunter.
We went the two of us into the woods behind the little school. Two went in and one came home. Didn't go in there alone. Your eyes were lovely as you danced with centipedes and little ants. We built a fort of lover's teeth and some of mother's sheets.
I have to charge my headset.
I was a boy and I was good.
And it beeped right on time with the music. And it was very weird. Alright,
they followed us into the trees.
This will be a three.
Wearing crowns of twigs and leaves. You and I were in the mud. And paint ourselves with spider's blood.
I'm just gonna fill these in here quick. Oh yeah, they can't do carrot tests.
Pulling legs off salamander.
Awesome.
Little creature you unspun.
And you know what? There's probably some fuck ups in there, but I will find out as we go. And adjust as needed, but for now when there's only like four things for them to do. Alright. We gotta build us. Fenced barn area. I'll include some nice water. Should be a good 10, right?
Dark and deep.
It's also have to build a marker. Oh, but I also have to put in pen marker to actually mark what animals can go in there. And I don't have enough animals to separate yet, so. We went the two of us into. The woods behind the little school. I'm still buried in the mud. Let's just get you prioritized on that. There you go. Leave that to somebody else. Lamp. And I like this. It gives you a whole thing about, like, the impressiveness and wealth and space. See, they build so quickly. In the other game I was playing, they do not build that quickly. Somebody else out there now. Alright. How many is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Start on the next test.
the child of the rain. A killer's gray, her hair.
Claimed their beds.
Cutting breeze, her laugh. There she disappears again.
Why? Oh, those are the animals. That there were people. I forgot.
Those days when I was
designate
with my love at last.
Animal spots.
Feel your
I think I have at least one that sits in a box.
She
right?
Is beautiful and
do iguanas fit in boxes?
The sky,
I don't know. I guess we'll find out.
She laughs at every foolish hope we owe. Winter is coming down. Crushing leaves like bones, my weary back can't carry more. All these memories,
okay.
Bitter show, you'll be the same.
Need warm clothes. It's not cold
before.
Yet.
Down the road.
Go, small people, running around on my screen.
But a bird flew by, so what I'd done, he
sat up in the nest outside, and he sang about what I'd become. He sang so loud, sang so clear, I was afraid all my neighbors would hear. Complex furniture, that's what I need. I promised I wouldn't do it again. But he said, I don't know the lines, I don't know the lines. That's the last time I'll ever sing. Broke his neck, done a lesson he wouldn't forget. More steel. From my mouth. Oh, good. They both fit in boxes. Demolish those steel walls so we can build us a kitchen and cook some food, because everybody's gonna fucking starve to death soon either way, and I'm gonna die. We're all gonna die. Everybody's gonna die. Good lord. Y'all better plant faster. Oh good, somebody's doing it. We'll be right back. Marble. I don't want marble. Deal. Baby, can you move the fuck to the kitchen? Are these deal? Medical. Go on. Get your treatment. I guess. I gave you a way to make food.
I don't see the problem.
Any more raw food?
Goodbye. No room for you on the right side. Out to the middle, then away.
you can't learn anything new.
I'm a river running fast and free.
Oh, a turtle! A tortoise! Another fucking squirrel. Why is he up? Yep. Come on, mother, daughter. Okay. And wait, do I only have one male? So, I have to actually enclose the pen. Jimmers. Good. Where is it? Where are the dandelions? That's what you want on there. buddy. You're just on an insulting spree. You're just gonna follow people around being a bitch. Great. Can't really do anything about it either. Look. I'm doing my best. Let's hunt some ibex. Get him! Get him! Get him! Oh no. I don't have any defenses! I'm not quiet, I'm not broken, but it's out of misery. Yeah, nobody knows. I have to have a thought process, hold up. Well, I guess we're just gonna watch how this plays out. It's a raid, but there's just one of them. Come on, guys. Like I'm in a liar in a state of mind. Yeah, I don't know how to fight this run. I only left you some. Cause I ain't living a fighting drunk. Yeah, nobody knows how long I've been waiting for death. Can't I do some? Ugh. The last in Roanoke. Yeah, I spent my summer there, but I'm not meant to call it home. Why is there just one person wandering around over there? What are you doing? And you said you can't believe how I could just choose to be mean. But it got me in the deep. Are you hauling the dead bodies back even? And if not, make me feel like I'm running out of light, like I'm running out of light and state of mind. When you say you think I'm running to be an actress, well, I said it. That's just a rolling movie and we're all waiting for the credits. Yeah, nobody knows how long I've been waiting for death. Yeah, nobody knows how long I've been waiting for death. I need something. I am missing something. And I don't know what. Yay! Gay shit. I love that gay shit. I love it. I love it. I love that gay shit. How long I've been waiting for death. Nobody knows. Nobody knows how long I've been waiting for death. No, 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 but no. Off to bed soon. Oh yeah, I guess it was a holiday today and not tomorrow. Knows how long I've been waiting. I might, good night, love you. I might switch to tryout not for broadcast soon. Cause I'm not liking the way that my current... Did they capture Oyster? Attack! No! Oh. I thought she was already kidnapped. See, I don't like the way that this one's going. So normally I would want to restart, but then I'm like, I'm streaming. People don't want to see me restart a million times because it's going to take me like 10 tries to get this going. You remember 1816 as the year without a summer. June 1816. A sudden snowstorm blankets all the countryside. Mary Shelley just stands on and she were Frankenstein. Oh, 1816 was the year without a summer. What does he do? Well, I have iguana.
Under these conditions, whoa, it was brought in and in pots. It goes from 95 degrees to freezing.
Ah, I love just watching little people run around on my screen making stuff. I forgot that I had a person named Iguana while also having an iguana named whatever I have it named. Losing my mouse. An explorer, years later, looking back at the past. Alright. Motherfuckers, alright.
I will give you my red color to take away your sickly pallor. For you are so very coloric of complexion. Please beware the mounting sun and all dejection.
Uh-oh. Psychotic state. Oh, buddy. What are you doing? Psychotic wandering. Okay, buddy. You do you. Buddy here can I need butcher. Oops. Maybe he can prioritize some butchering. There you go, buddy. And now maybe do some cooking? There we go. Let's get everybody not fucking starving. That would be good. Playlist is repeated. We're gonna just shuffle the good old liked songs. But not listen to all of them. That's a good one. In fairy tales. Meant for someone else, but not for me. Love is out to get me. That's the way it seems. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. This is so different because I'm. Hang on. I'm gonna give up on this one anyway, so I'm gonna load my on my own playthrough where I'm doing much better, but I started with new arrivals and not like tribes people.
If I try,
this is what I've got built on my regular playthrough. I'm building an electric workshop over here with a few wind turbines to power it. got all my growing fields, more growing my little defensive position. Why is there a wolf just wandering around? I got all kinds of animals. I only started with Bridget the warg. I do love Bridget. She's a nuisance. She just murders the fuck out of shit sometimes. A storeroom, a workshop, a medical hospital bay, the elite. My prison cell, which consists of Orange, a wild woman, who unfortunately I'm gonna sell into slavery. Sorry, y'all. It's worth a lot of money. I could release her, but there's no relations gain because she doesn't belong to anybody. And really, she'd probably just die in the wild anyway. Shouldn't be justifying digital slavery. But, I mean, it's part of the game. Down in my mind, I'm in love. But anyways, that's my main save. But we are gonna switch games after I go grab another beer and potentially pop some toast into a toaster. I am suddenly starving. But I'll be I'm gonna still be attached. So I can use the cheese. I'd like to grate some cheese over top of my toast. It's not just toast. I have cool shit on it and stuff, like lobster cake. No, it's crab cake, not lobster. Not that fancy. And I'm only fancy enough for crab cakes now because all food is so fucking expensive that you might as well buy the fancy stuff. pack of four crab cakes is $5. That's two meals for $5. I'm gonna pass that up. No fucking way. Alright, grated cheese. Now I'm gonna put my cheese back into a Ziploc bag. So I can. Oh my god! It keeps getting louder near the TV. I'll be shocked if you guys can't hear it once I sit down again. In hell, one and the same boy. Ooh. Heaven and hell, one and the same. Ba-da-ba-ba. Oh, I was gonna have a meat pie. I can't. Ah. Earlier I was thinking about the meat pies I had gotten. But I guess now I'm having this. Heaven and hell, boy, one and the same. Can't be true. I forgot a beer. I forgot to get the one thing that I really needed. Oh, 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 oh. Woo. Yeah! Best way I can. Heaven and hell, boy, one and the same. Boy, one and the same. In the middle. Oh, I think the microphone is picking it up. I just need to turn it up a little bit and turn off the music. Good. Good. All right, now I can switch you guys back over to see my desktop. It's gonna be good. I need this mouse. That's better. Alright, I'm gonna pause that. Turn this up. I think you guys will be able to hear what matters at least. Let's make sure there's subtitles if I can. No, that's weird. It sounded like it was coming through my headset. I'm like, no, it's not. So I think it is. It's gonna have subtitles on default color. It'll be fine. I'm sure it'll be fine. I just wanted to make sure they were on. So that in case you guys can't hear anything, you can at least read what I'm doing. Well, I've never played this before, so I really don't know what to expect. And I just hope that it is easy to pause when I have to go. Oh, no, I want to do Socks with Pockets 5. SWP 5. Without the stress. Let's go intern. I don't want to go full story mode. I'll probably play story mode on my own. But I've never played this before, so I have no idea what to expect. So this will be at least funny. While my food cooks. I forgot to put something on my food! I'll be 1 second. Oh my god. Oh, I hope it doesn't really start before I cut back. No! I didn't put spices. I white peopled my food. Don't start into anything I need to interact with. Please, for the love of God. It's already really rough how I'm spicing these. It's going to be very uneven. Oh, my God. Ugh. That was almost the whitest fucking food I've made in so long. Ugh. Oh, the election. Okay. Is there a phone to pick up? Where's the phone? Turn right. I smell like garlic. Oh no. Ooh. Miss November. Okay. Oh no. Don't wipe people your food. At least get some garlic powder and put it on things. That's at least. I put at least garlic powder and basil on as many things as I can. Look to my left. Oh god. Oh no! What? This is going to be very Five Nights at Freddy's.
You can see on the broadcast screen that we're in the end titles for the show before us. Fortunately, they go on for fucking ages, so there's plenty of time for me to explain. Oh, right, okay, they're over, so we haven't got to cancel the broadcast. Right, quickly, mate, look down under the desk.
Under. We're gonna go exercise with ham sleeves. Sounds really funny. We're gonna go My Salad Weekly and Crazy Neil. Oh, they're a little laggy. That's not my stream, that's the game.
Good evening, I'm Jeremy Donaldson. Our main story is tonight.
Okay, all good. Next is going to be the throw of the news titles on screen too. There'll be a countdown, but I'll count you in as well. Just relax, mate.
Oh, God.
Honest Andy's totally independent and corners the flawed market. Top chat. Sports fans everywhere celebrate as popular footballer Johnny Hamsley's wins.
Because I have to censor too, and oh no.
And a spoonful of sugar. Megan will be chatting with movie star Lawrence Bunderclatch about his new movie, The Medicated. And
what?
Grant Headquarters to hear what the of the special party have to say on their historic
visit. Right.
Two, one. Oh, God. When is it going to do it?
Here it comes. Switch to screen one. Now. Lovely night.
The votes are in, and it's a decisive win for advance.
We'll forget a bit of interference around this time, mate. Keep your eye on the machine at the bottom right. Use that slider that's flashing, or your scroll wheel to move the down,
but critics have accused him of a severe lack of actual policies and of being deliberately vague. The opposition parties have all conceded defeat to a overwhelming mandate, but have yet to appear publicly. However, former Home Secretary.
Right, it's going well. All you've got to do now is play the advert at the end of the segment. Make sure you don't play too early or we'll all get fired.
Oh, God.
The top is counting you down to the
Oh, the ham sleeves guy. Oh, God. No, no. Welcome home, Johnny, over on the side there. Jesus Christ. Oh, no. How do I switch back from the... Oh, God. This is difficult. I said to Peter, what a wild ride this has been.
I recommend that. That is fantastic. And am I right in saying that the character you're playing in this movie is quite an academic one?
Absolutely right. A scientist.
Was that a challenge at all?
But seriously, yes, you're right. It was a complete departure from my last starring role when I played Sergeant Brock Rockman in Bullet Man. You'll remember that that was the true story of one soldier's fight for a love that surpassed.
I can't go to her.
A love, of course.
I know, but I heard she was making a face like she was grossed out by him.
Most of all, I think I do it for the positive change that I can bring about in the world.
And today, of course, we're in for some real change, it looks like, in the coming few months. What do you make of this historic election result?
Oh, well, well, now you're asking. Historic election result. Indeed, historic is the word. Well, it's difficult, isn't it? Very difficult. But I think I've always been quite clear that when it comes to politics, that one should always strive to not fuck things.
Damn it.
Okay, don't panic. I'll explain how to deal with swearing at the break.
Which opens next week.
Right, I swapped the shot of Jeremy on screen one for a VT of the movie clip. You'll get a countdown on the screen, but just let Megan cue you in.
My character, Dr. Lance Hemlock, is faced with a decision that could affect humanity's very survival.
Exciting stuff. Let's take a look.
Ah! That was stressful. Oh, God. I need a break in this so I can go get my food. One.
Right, I guess I better explain how to deal with bleeping out swear words. As you probably noticed, the broadcast screen here is about 2 seconds behind the master screen.
Oh, God. Baseball. Oh, good. It's got a visual, like. Yeah, well, I'm not a professional yet. What?
As you turn it up, you'll hear the advert getting louder. Good. You're set to start censoring. Like I say, it takes a little practice, but I'll try and help you through it, and soon we'll have you bleeping like a pro. Remember, button lights up, count 1, 2, and hold it down. Remember to select screen 1 now that you've got the feed. Don't wait for the broadcast to go live. That's too late. You can use the number button.
Help whoever has to bleep this. Great. Don't make me multitask. Well.
Cut to the outside broadcast. Oh, shit. He's pissed. Get ready to play.
Thank you all for coming. Thank you all for coming. Well, what?
Where do I start? They said we couldn't do it. They said we couldn't. Every dirty, low-down lying, sodomy, low-down lying, southern bastard.
You only got a little word.
I'm sorry about the language there.
Sorry about that.
Shit. I'm on the wrong cameras, too.
Perhaps we should all be celebrating.
except for the rich.
For them the party's over. They shouldn't be celebrating.
I tried.
Before we came out here to address the nation,
I can't wait to be good at this. It's just so slashed. I love it. God damn it! Went long. That was rough. One. I said I hit one. Jiminy crickets. Yeah, it'll be me. It is so hard to listen to somebody twice in offset. Ah! It's the end of the broadcast? What? Cool. I gotta go grab my toast. Jesus Christ. It needs another couple of minutes, and then it's eating time. Oh. Sequence with D. Sequence. I know that last one was terrible. I do want more info. Yeah, that, God damn it, yeah, that's true. It was bad because I had to bleep him all the time. Some rude words were broadcast, interference-free show. That's good. An exceedingly poor edit. Look, that last one was hard. I had to multitask. God damn it. I'm not going to start the next one until I get to eat. So you all get to look at my awful last sequence sitting there staring at me. I'm upset about it. I gotta play some Death and Taxes. I keep, like, being like, oh, I should wait to play it on stream because there's the stream commands on chat and stuff. The chat commands, I mean. But, like, I'm like, I don't need to only play it on stream. Like, I'm allowed to play it by myself just because there is stream shit to do. You know, I can play it twice through. I don't think it's... It probably has some crazy story going on in the background of it, so that's, you know. But I will play it on my own and with stream. Same with this, not for broadcast. I'm going to be playing this on stream and off stream. We will see. We will see. I told, there was a Telus guy that came to my door, woke me up this morning. It was like almost noon though, so it's not like I'm upset about it. I was meaning to get up. My alarm was going off and I was just putting it off, and then a knock came to the door. And he was trying to get me set up with, like, Telus. They're giving away, like, free security systems and stuff. And, of course, things always come back around to me telling some kind of lore story. And I just tell him, like, one tiny part of something, and he just is like, what? That's crazy! So I gave him all of my my socials. So hopefully he joins us one of these nights and gets to see the crazy, because I was like, yeah, I've got a Discord, and it's like a whole like meme thing is that like there's socks lore, and I have to put socks lore trigger warning. But I was just approved recently for CVAP, which gives me funding for security system type stuff, so hopefully maybe I can work that in with getting Telus. I don't know, I have an appointment tomorrow to talk with somebody about random things, and that'll be my thing, internet, getting internet set up better, because I am with Shaw, and I am like hooked up with Shaw right now, but they suck. They don't have, like, a disability discount, and they don't, like, I was kind of screwed into being with them in the first place. It's just a whole thing, so I'd like to switch to Telus, but get to go tomorrow to find that out. Oh my god, food, are you done? I'm so hungry! Hungry for my crab toast. Crab toast. Crab toast. I'm hungry for my crab toast. Crab toast. Crab toast. Get my utensils early. I'm hungry for my crab toast. Crab toast. Crab toast. I'm hungry for my crab toast. Crab toast. Crab toast. I didn't change my description. It still probably says I'm playing RimWorld. Yeah, it does. Let's switch that over to not. There's a VR version of this. That would actually be pretty fucking sick, I gotta say. Oh, I guess I have to change this too. There we go. I'm not great at bleeping. Alright, hold up. This should be done. I also got a lot of cleaning done in my kitchen with all of my boxes and stuff because my mom was in town and was very helpful. Give me my toast! Toast oven! There's cheese from the last thing I had in there and it's sticking to my toast. Oh, yeah, she smells so good. She smells so good! Check this out, guys. Check this out. I don't want my toast to fall off the plate. See? Lobster cakes. You put a little mayo and hot sauce down. Lobster cake, cheese, basil, garlic. And you got yourself a fancy meal. Fancy eatins. Now excuse me while I fancy eatins. Oh, God. Sorry, I didn't realize how hungry I was. Hungry. And it's so good. Nom nom. Little ASMR. Crunchy. Crunchy ASMR. Holy fuck, that's so good. Oh my god! It is so good. song. I wish I could share flavors through stream. Like, there should be something that y'all can, like, put in your mouth, and then it offshoots, like, flavor profiles. Because that would be amazing. That would also be amazing for VR. I've always wondered what Nuka-Cola tastes like. Does it taste like Coca-Cola? Or is it more nuclear? It can't be exactly the same. And, like, you know, Coca-Cola was called that because it had coca plant in it. Cocaine. So Nuka-Cola, is it called that because it has nuclear waste in it? Where's the logic there? What makes my cola Nuka? And I'm sure at some point in the games they explain what Nuka-Cola is made of. And why it's called that and all that. But, I don't know. Which is funny because usually I get right into follow lore. Oh my god. Somebody should do just a series. I'm sure there is one of follow lores. Just like MatPat does with FNAF lore. Which I'm pretty sure I'm going to be unsubscribing as soon as I am done that final thing. But that's a whole different thing. Got your mom a Fitbit. Like, I ate something before starting stream. It's only been an hour and a half. Why am I so hungry now? Smoosh your crab cake out onto your toast. So your toast gets all covered. These have big sleeves. But they're not green. Quality. Some crunchy ASMR. Some weird VH or CRT TV looking shit. Nom, nom, nom. I'm almost done my second piece. Then we can get back into the game. I know there's some like weird fucking story behind this game. Like shit goes on like outside your window and stuff. Like, so right now we just saw that there was a weird election where some really drunk guy got apparently elected, and they're gonna go crazy and do some shit with rich people. I don't know. But hopefully they come up with a new law that says you're fully allowed to swear on TV because I hate bleeping people. That's gotta be the hardest part of this game because it just... Even listening to the offset talking is just like, ah! But I'll get it. I like getting good at difficult things. Ooh. Oh. This is one that got extra hot sauce by accident. Ooh, that Cholula be good. If you're not eating Cholula, are you even eating hot sauce? No. I'm sure there's better hot sauces out there, but... I love me some Cholula. Oh, I just got into a part that has more basil on it than other parts. And that's why you don't white people your food. Have you ever tasted basil? It's fucking delicious. Have you had garlic? It comes in a powder. Regular garlic hurts my tummy. But garlic powder, that's fine. Even pepper. I used to not like pepper. Like, I hated pepper. But recently, I've been putting it in things, and it's been okay. I think it was more of a sensory thing, and now I'm kind of... Once you realize that, it gets better. Oh, my God. It's so spicy. Oh, you have to give me a minute. Oh, get a Kleenex that I don't have by my computer because it's actually toilet paper. So I have to go all the way to my bathroom to get something to wipe my nose. That is now all spicy drippy. Spicy drippy. Okay. Let's do this. We're going to continue. Ooh. Okay. Well, I care about shares. I love watching the stock market because I'm usually very good at predicting it, but I don't want to participate in it because it is the main motivating factor as to why people care more about profits than people. And so I refuse, but like, does it actually give me options to look at how the stocks are doing? Like, I'm good at it. That is something like I'm currently watching, what is it, TMC stock, because of some offshore mining probabilities coming up. So I'm watching it to see if it goes up. So far it hasn't, but I mean, we're still in the early stage. Okay. Oh.
National Nightly News. But before that, let's take a look at what's coming up later on tonight on Channel 1. At 7 o'clock, it's the semi-final of the quotation game, and it's a nail-biting quiz tonight with a team of nuclear physicists.
So BBC.
That's followed at 8 p.m. by award-winning documentary series The Shape of Now, which tonight looks at the history of the knee-length
The Shape of Now.
Its importance during the Great Blackouts of 1871. Not one to miss. At 9 p.m, sit back and relax with multiple award-winning movie, The Freedom of Being Colin, taking us all the way up to 11:15, where, as usual, Dr. Adrian Atkinson...
This is wonderfully BBC.
...incises, and tonight sees a return for leading economist Katie Brightman. ...midnight, it's the National Weather Report, before we say goodnight until tomorrow. But now, join me and Donald for the National...
Fast forward. This was all very straightforward stuff. I hate that it's, like, laggy. Like, is it supposed to be jumpy like that?
The votes are in, and it's a decisive...
Uh-huh. Then there was Johnny Hamsleeves.
I'll take you through a proper match day workout with my two cracking assistants. Who knows, within a few weeks, you could be as fit as them.
The effeminate ice skater, the nosy photographer. Jesus Christ.
Did you know that fat people are less likely to laugh marathons?
These potentially true statistics. I love it. I can't. Oh my god.
I do hope you believe in my tale. The deal this evening today is among the greatest joys of
life. See my cuts in this.
Filming your latest movie, which is called The Medicated.
The Medicated, yes.
Wow, what was that like?
Why did he say it like that?
I said to Peter at the rat. That's Peter Jensen, the director. Do you know him? He's a wonderful chap. He really is. And I've worked with him on
Dick.
Several movies, all terribly successful. I said to Peter...
Alright, yeah. I cut this pretty good. It's the bleeping I want to get to. Let's go!
Lord's Hemlock is faced with a decision...
Right, there's the whole commercial that comes up after this.
The sterility. This odor. This odor. This is the key. Yes, yes, we could stop it all. We have to ask ourselves. If we should.
Oh, God. My salad weekly. Let's get to the drunk guy.
They use every dirty, low-down, lying, southern bastard against
I missed it totally.
People, you saw right through
language there.
Sorry about that. I've had a couple of celebratory pints. Course of them is funny.
Oh, I was bad. Okay. That's all I wanted to see was me fuck up on that.
Rushes. It's pretty simple. The four screens you can see, they're going to show you the four signals you got from the studio during the actual broadcast. Difference is you can mute any combination of them so you can never listen to the stuff you weren't allowed to show.
Ah. There was one where they started talking. Come on, load.
these aren't my cards. Please tell me these aren't my cards.
No, they're the right ones, apparently.
But this gives me nothing, Jenny. They must see that.
I know. I think they think you won't have anything to say.
Oh, for God's sake, come on. It's a huge day. It's not an...
Absolute bogey. I don't care, Rob. I'm not doing it. I agree to do one beastly interview a day. I made that completely clear when we started. Check my contract.
Hi, I'm Megan.
Oh, piss off. You're on thin bloody ice, Rob. Whole wheat, man. Whole wheat.
We're coming back from the break. Quiet in the studio.
Thank you so much.
10 seconds, everybody.
Oh, God. All right, now it's...
Sergeant Brock Rock. A love, of course, for freedom. I think it's grossed over $1 billion, but honestly, who's counting?
It's a role that saw you scoop 2 Best Actor awards, if I remember correctly.
That's so sweet of you to mention it, but I really am not in it for the awards.
All right, let's see her his freak out.
The statues do take pride of place on my mantelpiece.
With all the others, I'm sure. So, if you're not doing it for the awards, what is it then that drives you?
Oh, that is a beautiful question, Megan, and not easy to answer. Like you, I'm afraid. Cut me.
Come on!
Where my character, Dr. Lance Hemlock, is faced with a decision that could affect humanity's very survival.
Exciting stuff. Let's take a look.
And we're out.
Rob, get the car ready.
Mr. Blundercatch.
No! I'm shutting this down. What kind of operation are you people running?
Mr. Blundercatch, I understand you're upset.
Upset! You're the half of it. Rob! I'll be at the door seat. Send up a bottle of scotch and a whole ham. Contract.
And a whole ham.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I just had to. Well, go on then. Say it.
What?
I told you so.
Your hair look nice.
See, this is why you're single.
Oh my gosh. Alright, then it's... Oh, stop. Now, advance acceptance play. God damn. Ah! That little part of the interface is stupid.
Southern bastard trick they had against us, but you, the people.
Come on, load up. I want to get to where. Come on.
This one?
hear it through theirs. It's steel. They got some awkward tension, don't you think? Why is it so jumpy? Like, I'm not running anything else. Is this game supposed to be a little jumpy like that, or is it just my computer? Come on, say something weird. Say something that gives me a little tidbit of lore. Give me the lore! Give it to me. Come on. All right. So they're even surprised by his decisions. Come on, give me more. Alright, I don't think there's anything else in that. So. And then adverts. No. Alright, let's try another day that I'll fail at. An unexpected form. What? You arrive home to find posts on the mat, most being nothing more than the usual junk mail. One letter, however, catches your eye. The team wants to know you. Curiosity gets the better of you when you open it. It's a form from the new advanced government asking for information on all citizens. Oh god, the first page is filled in already. Your name, your spouse. So I'm Alex Winston, and I'm married to Sam Winston. That's creepy. Very dokey dokey. And I have two kids, Charles and Susie, 14 and 19. Well, you muse, at least they got the basics right. The rest of the questions are left for you to complete. They appear to be mandatory. Question one. Oh, God. Upon starting a new job, you would be friendly and introduce yourself to your coworkers. Be productive and get to work immediately. Ease yourself in and orient yourself at the new workplace. Reminisce about with friends about old jobs. I'm going to go be friendly and introduce myself. Question two. A colleague in a different department has confided in you that they've been taking home confidential information. Now, a file of minor importance has gone missing. You would help your colleague cover up their violation. Recommend that your colleague reports it. Promise your colleague that you won't tell anyone. Report immediately. I would say that I would recommend my colleague. An entire department was fired today for consistent underperformance. Your boss has put in place new targets that are significantly higher than the previous ones. You would leave work on time, stay late to ensure that you hit the first deadline, leave work early and head to the pub and chat about the changes with colleagues, leave work early and head home to see your family. I'd leave work on time. Quiet quitting, baby! I really don't like this doki-doki-ass shit going on over here. It's the annual company barbecue, and you and your family have been invited. You are looking forward to go enjoying a nice day out with friends and family. Are washing your hair that day? Go if you're free, but wouldn't mind missing it. Have been practicing with your coworkers, and think you'll win the talent contest here. I'll say, looking forward to. I like barbecues. I want to do there's free food. You've had a long, successful career and are now about to retire. In your speech, you list your achievements and all the good memories you have of working there. Give an honest review of the pros and cons of the company. Focus on issues and challenges you faced while working there. Refuse to attend. Give an honest review. In your spare time, you like to relax alone, doing things like listening to music or making models. Attend political rallies. My bad. I forgot the sound's not coming through this anymore, and it was dying. Political rally, stand up for what you believe in, encourage and support your children with their hobbies, play in your local sports team. If I answer this, they're going to be upset with me. Let's do that one. Your ideal holiday getaway would be surrounded by natural beauty, getting away from the strain of the daily grind, exploring somewhere unfamiliar and discovering new experiences, a structured day at a theme park with thrills and attractions, a romantic getaway. I'm going to go exploring somewhere unfamiliar. It is most important that the government keeps people safe, free, happy, or equal. Equal. Thank you for your cooperation. Advance knows your time is valuable, and we appreciate your help in leading the nation to a brighter future. Sign your name. And I am broke ass poor. Day 6 of Family Matter. Aren't I supposed to be doing more TV things? It's late. Sam and the kids have gone to bed. You're just drying up a favorite coffee cup, a worn out souvenir from your first trip together. The prints faded up. But the goofy face still makes you smile. A knock at the window brings you back to reality. There in the garden, clutching a gaudy neon green suitcase, is Chris, Sam's sibling. As soon as you let him in, they sit at the kitchen table, visibly stressed. Chris takes a deep breath. I'm so sorry for bursting in so late. Alex, Chris stammers, but I need a favor and you're the only one I can ask. Are you okay? Should I go get Sam? No need to worry, Sam. It's you I came here to see. I just need 2 minutes. You've heard about the Assets and Wealth Act? I literally work in news, Chris. Chris's fist bangs on the table. It's total bullshit. They're taking whatever they want and distributing it as they see fit. I mean, if you're taking it from the rich, I'm pretty okay with that. No government should have that kind of power. I can't believe they're actually getting away with it. Madness, which is why I need your help. Why do I get a feeling I'm not going to like this, or what exactly is it you need? If we're going to go with what exactly is it? Chris's eyes seem to be resting comfortably on the floor tiles. Look, I know it's a lot to ask, but I need to borrow your passport. My passport, what for? Or my passport, I can't give you that, it's illegal. I'm going to go, what for? They've taken away mine and half the bloody countries, but people always say you and I look similar, so Chris is pacing now. I need to leave before it's too late. Once I'm out, me and my money will be safe. I don't want to help this guy, me and my money. Like, not even, like, your family will be safe. Ugh. But I need to go now before they freeze my accounts. Please, Alex, I wouldn't ask if they had any other choice. Surely there's another way. It can't be that serious. Chris's mouth falls open. You're joking, right? I've always done right by you and Sam. You're trying to run away to protect your money while a government is going crazy instead of, like, trying to take your sister? I'm not helping him. Fine, I'll solve this myself, Chris Spitz. So much for family loyalty, eh? I don't know, were you planning on paying me? I didn't hear an offer of millions of dollars or something, because those are the people they're going to target, you dinger. Grabbing the neon fluorescent suitcase, Chris disappears into the night. You go back to the dishes, picking up Sam's cup again. Peeling face now seems to bore into you. The knot in your stomach tightens. Ha! Ah, I got the achievement, screw the 1%. Oh, I've got puppet strings. Did I always have puppet strings on that picture? Oh, it does! Oh! It's just cut off in the other picture. Look at it. The fallout. This is great. Open the windows. What?
Right, let's load up the adverts. You might want to have a bit of a think about it. Your decisions have consequences, don't they?
Should we play this? Is this toy safe? Mr. Snugglehugs? Ooh, I really want to watch it! Oh. Part of me wants to be really good in this playthrough, but part of me thinks that would be very funny in this playthrough. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Funny or not funny? Funny or not funny? Dense Fist's must have toy for yard. Alright, I gotta see it. I gotta. Jus de cochon. That's pig juice. An elegant new skin cream with a porky little twist. Gross. An advanced go-getters. Teen team. I could make comparisons to some other government programs like that, but I'm not gonna. I'll let y'all do that yourself. Okay. You pick image A on the left bottom screen here, or image B on the right bottom screen here. It's really simple. This little clock here will count down the number of seconds you have to make your decision. Oh. Okay. I was gonna switch, but already heard from overseas. I'll be asking my guests whether Advance can deliver on even a fraction of their manifesto promises. Now, with the old Remington Swiss have appointed Sophia Remington as their new CEO. The following photo, taken from our archive, gives us a sense of this influential young firebrand who, at the tender age of 23, becomes the youngest female CEO in history. Sophia Remington has always impressed. She was top of her class at university and graduated with the highest honors. Immediately being asked that,
like tense.
The
markets have responded favorably to Sophia's appointment, with stocks rising 30 points in light of the announcement. In her first press conference this afternoon, Sophia announced a children's toy named Mr. Snugglehugs. Sophia promises it'll be all the rage this Christmas, but concerns have been raised about the product's safety. Intrepid scientist Dr. David Wong, a marine biologist in Morgan Horgensford, have today set off the recently discovered cloud system was previously thought unreachable,
The difference, that's so funny.
The pair hope to successfully reach the imposing central cavern and the undiscovered plant species it contains. This is, of course, only the latest in a series of successful expeditions for this unlikely pairing. In a joint statement about the dangers their team might face, the pair stated, "We will face the plentiful challenges together like we always have." Playing the field, rumors about because sporting legend Johnny Hamsley is now leaving Bush.
Ooh.
The footballer was caught while out celebrating being named Sports Personality of the Year last week. As reported,
we're gonna go pukey picture.
And judging from the angle and velocity of that spray, it looks like Johnny may have been celebrating a little bit too much. I certainly wouldn't want to be his dry cleaner. And grievous bodily charm. With advance promising a radical new position of mine, how afraid should we actually be? I'll be going live around the country to talk with people who've seen the criminal justice system from every perspective. With more and more powers passing to the police, and less oversight, are we using an advanced-shaped sledgehammer to crack a nut? All that, a mega move for the group of young actors already experiencing the positive side of the new assets and wealth act firsthand. They'll be talking and performing later. That's all coming up on tonight's National Nightly News.
What was just... Oh, God.
Swift enactment of the Assets and Wealth Act, we're talking about Advance's first week in office and what the new future holds. Joining me are Katie Brightman, a leading economist, and Alan James, author of
Oops.
Alan James is Right, The Free Man's Guide to the government certainly haven't dragged their heels on delivering some of the legislation they promised. But what does the Wealth Act mean for us?
Nothing, Jeremy. We're still vassal slaves, we're just in prettier cages.
A confident dismissal there. Katie Brightman, do you agree?
I'm afraid I don't, no. I think that Vance have realised that the current economic system of unlimited, unending growth is untenable, so they're changing things up.
There I agree with you. They're moving to the next steps in the grand plan.
Grand plan, Alan?
It's all in my book. Alan James is right, Jeremy. We're to become the great herd. Ignorant, sterile, and short-lived. That's what they want.
Or perhaps Advance have just realised that if we carry on the way we are, we will destroy ourselves and this planet in a mad orgy of consumption, if you'll excuse the colourful metaphor.
Yes, orgy is the right word. Only it'll be the overlords having an orgy on our poor broken backs. It's all in my book. Alan James is
shamelessly self-promoting. Katie, how do you think the rest of the world will respond to this new approach?
I think they're watching carefully. Advance are the most disruptive...
They took his book.
Since the last great war.
Yes, Katie's right. War is inevitable.
Thank you, but that isn't...
And this will not be a war like we've ever seen before. We're talking millions of deaths. We're talking high-tech weapons that can level entire cities. We're talking
out of the wrong orifices.
Mock me all you like, Jeremy, but when they murder your parents and they poison your food and they take you away to their camps for hypno-brainwashing, we'll be laughing then.
That might be a great way to sell books, Alan, but you know full well that isn't going to happen in a democracy.
Democracy is dead.
Yes, Advance are radical, and change is always frightening, but the truth is that the Wealth and Assets Act has made more than 90% of the population wealthier, and is on target to produce a permanent end to poverty.
Bollocks! What this young lady doesn't understand, Jeremy, is that these are the same people.
I tried!
Maybe they've rebranded, but it's all a little circus act to keep us from seeing the tyrant behind the curtain.
That's where you're wrong, Alan.
I didn't want to put it back to that guy.
Generation to walk happily into eternal bondage. They're like psychic paedophiles.
But based on the facts, Katie, what are your positions?
The Assets and Wealth Act is only the first step. Advance now have a historic budgetary surplus, and as well as properly funding our public services, they're already funneling unprecedented amounts into scientific research and the arts.
Or, as I call them in my book, Frankenstein.
He has another book. Oh my God.
Like opiates.
Can we get back to the issue at hand, please, Alan?
This is the issue. It's all coming from the water, the chemicals. They're pumping it full of belief juice.
Don't get me wrong. I want to see changes, but only if they're sustainable. If advance lose their power after spending half of our GDP on dismantling infrastructure, that could be catastrophic.
The catastrophe is that they're succeeding. They've got a sack here talking about their puppet show.
All right, we're running out of time. Quickly, Alan. What does the future look like to you, Alan?
A bleak space where we've all been figuratively sodomized into submission.
No, of course. Katie?
We might be on the eve of a brave new world. God knows we need some change, but we need to be cautious. Let's walk forwards with our eyes open.
Two very different visions of the future there. Alan James, Katie Brightman, thank you for joining me. When we come back, I'll be investigating law and order before Megan meets the beneficiaries of the assets and welfare. That's all coming up tonight on the National Nightly News.
1 minute back.
I think I went too early on that.
Some good.
Now what's Mr. Snuggle Hugs?
Shut the fuck up, Alan. I've never heard so much shit in my life.
Well, this is for a shit, won't we?
I can explain it to you, but unfortunately, I can't understand it fully.
Well, I don't know what you meant by that.
If you keep me happy, I'll keep you safe. Ah! Oh no.
Not a good time, darling.
It never is, is it? I'll be at my mother's.
Just hang on. Oh, the problem isn't a local one, Jeremy. It's nationwide. Just Jeremy Thomas.
I don't know what to do. It's awkward. I went to him too soon.
Do you think there's a problem with the system, Bob? Do you think
there's a problem? Oh, I'm sure we all do.
Seeing them going.
I'm sure we all long for a return to the day.
Ah, 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 ah.
The streets of your community are nice, looking in through windows and generally enjoying your neighbours without the risk of being terrorised by some thug with a knife. Or, gosh.
So you feel the streets simply aren't safe anymore?
This is so hard.
Well, that's not a simple question, Jeremy, but I think it all comes down to moral decay. We've diluted our culture and lost touch with what it means to be a citizen of this once great country. Also, as the vicar noted in Sunday's sermon, we probably shouldn't have banned hanging.
Oh, God.
And to what do you attribute?
Ah! This is so hard. Oops.
It's all in the Bible. Look, Leviticus states that... Oh, Leviticus, by the hang on a moment, Jeremy...
What in... I can't even. What in the... Everybody's working from home these days. I can't. Oops. Fuck!
Okay, well, we're trying to get back to that party as soon as possible. First, let me ask you this. Do you feel that your time spent in prison helped to rehabilitate you in any way, Tony?
Titwank Tony! I don't think it's as easy as that, Jez. I think asking that is an oversimplification.
It sounds like it's getting quite busy there, Tony, but...
Oh, God.
Since we've been in custody, have you been able to find a new job?
Yeah, all the boys are here. Big Chris.
Oi, oi.
Little Chris. Hands up, bye, Chris.
What?
Yeah. One sec, love. Chipmunk's on the list. One sec, love. Rehabilitation difficult with the current system, Jez. Just not set up for it, you know? It's inherently unjust, you know?
So, do you feel tempted to... I'm sorry, who's this guy?
No, you are joking. Christy Free Bullets has only got Mr. Fancy, oh.
I'm trying, guys. I am trying my darndest. That's amazing. Thespians. Oh no. Should I be on two? Okay, cool. Oops, god damn it.
Harriet and Trey were really the ones who came up with the whole idea.
Harriet and I were shooting the breeze in the cafeteria, and I said to the breeze, it's actually dips.
So I went to look for a drama teacher.
But she'd been laid off due to budget. Fortunately, I directed a pantomime when I was at university, so I knew the ropes, as it were.
Right, yes, but you're the math teacher, aren't you?
is going on here? Oh, God.
Put into context, I play a young first year who's having some troubles at school.
Her character doesn't actually have a name, yeah? Because in a way, she's like
all of us. It's like a metaphor.
In case they swear.
Maybe she's you.
That's really important.
Yeah, thanks, Steve.
Put it in, coach.
Yes, thanks, Steve.
While you run off and get ready. I can't wait to see it. That's it, that way. So, Jeff,
oh,
what did
God.
You first hear about the grass?
This is a hard game.
From advance arrived at the school. Now, the headmaster thought it was all a prank, but his secretary retrieved it from his bin and brought it to me.
Wow, how did you react?
I also threw it in the bin. But then, Harriet and Trey rescued it, and they rang the number at the bottom of the page, and next thing you know, we're on tour.
Wow. Well, I think we can all guess which way you'll be voting from now on.
Do you know what is funny? Because Angela and I don't usually vote. We're not very political. I'm a mathematician, of course, and she's a paraplegic, mainly. But we did used to watch that Peter Clements DIY show back in the day, and so we thought, why not? Let's have a go with this old democracy thing.
Okay.
And here we bally well are.
Good stuff.
Fucking brilliant.
So, let's have a look at a short section of... God
damn it.
Hey, friendship. Dear diary. Not sure I can take another day at this school. Another day of tears.
Tears.
Another day of fears. Still I walk the corridors alone.
Alone.
Dreading what might be around every corner.
What's around the corner? What's around the corner? What's around the
Oops.
Corner? Oh, hi Gary. Oh heavens no, it's Gary the Fist.
Gary the Fist.
Going somewhere, little first year?
Great. I've been looking for some poor victim to bully all morning. But will this make me feel better about my violent father?
Violent father.
Excuse me, I'm late for maths. It's my favourite subject. And so important.
Oh, God.
Maths is for losers.
What?
Maths is for losers.
My arm's stuck, coach.
Keep going, for fuck's sake.
Right, maths is for losers.
Oh, God damn it, I missed it. I forgot I had to do that. Oh, God.
Thank you.
Whoops. God, this is awful. Number three is looking back at what's his name. Jesus. What the literal fuck?
I believe I've got a 14-inch cock, but let's make it so.
I have a similar belief about an adequate paycheck.
Oh, someone please get these twats out of my studio.
Oh, Lord. This game's so weird. And I love it. Yeah, that middle one sucked. I had too much to keep track of at once. Oh my god. Look at this. Yeah. It's terrible. It's interference free though. Yeah, I know. The timing seems to be off on the actual, like, place where it shows red to bleep. Because it doesn't actually work so good. Yep. Okay, there was a couple of, parts that were really funny that I wanted to see what people were actually saying.
Kid, Mr. Hucklehugs or something.
Snuggle hugs?
That's the bastard.
Yeah, I wouldn't get one of those. My friend Janet says theirs gets really hot.
Is this Janet who thinks dogs have their own secret language?
Yeah, the one that mistrusts the moon. 10 seconds, everybody!
Not the best source of consumer advice, then.
Don't blame me when it explodes, going 5, 4, 3.
I gotta see that the interview that happened where the guy was getting left by his wife. Oh my god. And then I'm gonna have to save and quit and it's gonna be end stream. I don't wanna burn myself out. Come on.
Oh, that's a mega move for the group of young actors. Already experiencing the positive side of the new Assets and Wealth Act firsthand. They'll be talking and performing later. That's all coming up on tonight's National Nightly News.
10 seconds back, everybody. Can we get the guests in quickly, please?
We actually had to make the book indestructible because people tried to set it on fire too much. It's like,
thanks for coming on.
Thanks for having me.
Alan James, no doubt you've read my stuff.
I try not to, if I'm honest.
Behave.
You're not the boss of me.
I literally am.
I literally
Ten
am.
10 seconds, everybody.
This is wonderful.
We're going in 5, 4, 3, 2.
In the wake of the government's swift enactment of the Assets and Wealth Act, we're talking about advances first week in office.
Okay.
And what the new future...
These idiots for a while.
Is shamelessly self-promoting.
coming from the water. The chemicals.
Oh wait, no, it was Learn Order. Stop play. This is the one where there was that guy getting left by his wife in the background. Oh man.
I'm just saying I'll do what I can, that's all.
Bullshit, you will. She's good, you know she is.
I've said a better word and that's all I can do.
10 seconds, everybody. Little Jake, you scared of the big bird caught you with water.
If that sticks, I'll just
five. Four, three.
Welcome back.
Yeah, gosh, just...
We're going to be taking a state of law and order in our country. Advance have already tasked what they are calling a solutions team to move this serious social problem to the top of the list. Tonight, we go behind the headlines to meet the people who live with the criminal justice system every day of their lives. First up, we have Gregory Judge, a lawyer who sees the problems close up.
This is going to be so good.
Can you hear me, Gregory?
Yes, I've got you, Jeremy. Thanks for having me.
What's it like on the front line of the hard face of the cold hand of justice?
Well, as you can imagine, Jeremy, we are massively understaffed in this country. We're working every hour we can just to try and cope with the caseloads on our desk.
Which must affect the quality of support you can offer.
Well, we can barely keep up with the demand, Jeremy. There just simply isn't enough being done at a systemic level to relieve the problem. We need more support from ministers. We need change at a structural level,
I'm
Jeremy.
I'm leaving, Greg.
Not
a good time,
though.
I'll be at my mother's.
Just hang on. No, the problem isn't a local one, Jeremy. It's nationwide. Just give me 5 minutes. I'm talking to Jeremy Donaldson.
Oh, have you mentioned your affairs?
No.
Ha!
Well, the affairs of the Justice Department that we should be concerned about...
Hello, Mr. Donaldson.
Hello, Mrs. Judge.
We need legislation to relieve the pressure on our public
service. One second.
Sorry to interrupt the news, Mr. Donaldson. Can I have a moment to tell my husband I'm leaving him?
Yes, I totally understand. Quite the picture of a burdened legal sector there. Gregory Judge, thank you for joining us. Next, I'm joined by Police Chief Constable Bob Peel, a man with a very different perspective
you,
on our nation's crime. Do you think there's a problem with the system,
Bob? When are you going to realise?
Oh, I'm sure we all do, Jeremy. I'm sure we all long for a return to the days when you could safely walk the streets of your community at night, looking in.
Ah, wait, hang on.
Greg.
Oh, trust me, between the drinking and the arse, I'm very aware.
Ah, I didn't go back far enough.
Just give me 5 minutes. I'm talking to Jeremy Thomas.
Okay, here we go.
Have you mentioned your affairs?
No. Well, the affairs of the justice...
You gotta cut up your, thingies.
Hello, Mr. Donaldson.
Hello, Mrs. Judge.
We need legislation to relieve the pressure on our public service.
Sorry to interrupt the news, Mr. Donaldson. Can I have a moment to tell my husband I'm leaving him?
Yes, I totally understand. Quite the picture of a burdened legal sector there. Gregory Judge, thank you for joining us.
Oh.
I cannot believe you, Ellen. I would have expected this from your sister, but not from you.
With her sister.
Greg.
Ugh.
Trust me, between the drinking and the arse, I'm very aware.
That's how he ends it? Oh my god.
You're being terrorized by some thug with a knife.
Now I gotta listen to just his side of the gimp suit guy. Oh my god. So fucking funny.
We've diluted our culture and lost touch with what it means to be a citizen of this once great country. Also, as the vicar noted in Sunday's sermon, we probably shouldn't have banned hanging.
And to what do you attribute this moral decay?
Foreigners, gays and gypsies mainly. It's all in the Bible. Look, Leviticus clearly states that... Oh, bugger, hang on a moment. Jeremy, your bloody gimp's escaped. Delia, could you give me a little help, please, dear? As I was saying, Jesus didn't like immigrants much, did he?
And just to be clear, you think it's the immigrants who are responsible for the moral decay?
Absolutely, Jeremy. Back in your box, Chloe. Back in your box. See here, I'm bringing you back.
Oh God. Sorry.
Well, it is certainly not the responsibility of the decent, good, white people.
Darling, where's the padlock?
Oh, hold on just a moment. I am not having this again.
Mummies, get back in your boxes. Naughty, you beast cut.
As I was saying, Jeremy.
Moral decay.
When our daughter Alice comes home with an A-, does she go on a killing spree? No, she takes 3 of her pills and hides under the stairs like a normal child.
This guy.
Many happy returns, Tony.
The fucking clown in the background.
Tit-whack, Tony. Everybody else does.
No, I'm not going to be doing that. That's what it's like in prison, Tony.
Tit-whack, Tony.
Yay!
Prison's a mixed bag. The structure's quite nice, but it's a constant battle against institutionalization, as you can imagine. And obviously, tit-whacks are quite hard to come by.
I'm picking up that you're not alone there, Tony.
Tit-whack, Tony.
Yay!
Yeah, sorry, my friends are throwing me a surprise party. Good bunch of lads.
Okay, well, we're trying to get back to that party as soon as possible. First, let me ask you this. Do you feel that your time spent in prison helped to rehabilitate you in any way, Tony?
Tit, whack, Tony!
Whee!
I don't think it's as easy as that, Jez.
Open!
I think asking that is an oversimplification.
It sounds like it's getting quite busy there, Tony, but let's try and soldier on. Since we've been in custody, have you been able to find a new job?
Yeah, all the boys are here. Big Chris.
Oi, oi.
Little Chris.
Oi, oi.
And Vampire Chris.
Hello, Vampire Chris.
This one, yeah?
Yep.
One sec, love. Chitwing Tony's on the news. Rehabilitation's difficult with the current system, Jez. It's just not set up for it, you know? It's inherently unjust.
So, do you feel tempted to... I'm sorry, who's this guy?
You are joking. Chrissy Free Bollocks has only got Mr. Fancy,
oh. Oh my God.
Not now, fellas, I'm on the news.
It seems like we've caught
you. The little boy.
Oh, I can't really hear you, mate.
There's so much I missed going on.
Yes, we
I like that they let you watch through it again. Because there's so much you... like miss out on because you're paying attention to the game.
Well, we're just trying to get that signal back.
Although now for the future I will not be paying as much attention to what's going on in the game. Hey, if you've never been to a party like that, that's not his fault. Wonderful.
1 minute back, everybody.
That went well. Piss off.
Incisive journalism.
I can have you fired.
You'd miss my charm.
Let's see what people had to say in the background on this one. This is hilarious. I wish more people were watching the stream right now. All the best streams go to waste. I guess not totally, because it will go up on my YouTube, but like... Ah! I'm going to try to do Monday or Sundays from now on.
Dressing room, probably banging his head against the wall.
Look, it's all right. I've got this.
I'm sure he's on his way.
Because I've got, like, nothing in the mornings to do that day, so I can start stream early and then everybody can be here. Or at least whoever's available. I mean, Sundays most people are available, right?
Welcome, Splat. I'm Megan Wolf, and on tonight's Culture Spot, I'll be chatting with...
Okay, so this is through the interview.
We are, Megan. We're overwhelmed, to be honest. And I believe
can you hear anything over that one?
Yes,
God damn.
My oldest.
Since it's all in the same room, I'm guessing nobody's going to talk.
So I knew the ropes, as it were.
Right, yes, but
yeah, I think you can't hear anything extra because all of the cameras are just on them. Now, what was the Mr. Snuggle Hugs? What is this dangerous, potentially dangerous toy?
Kids, you love them, we love them, and they just love
Mr. Snugglehugs! Yeah!
With his state-of-the-art human-like voice to keep them company when you can. And his incredible real-action eyes. It's no wonder Mr. Snugglehugs is the gift your child wants this Christmas.
All the other kids have got one.
That's right, little one. You don't want to be left out. Oh, Mr. Snugglehugs, you're so silly. Mr. Snugglehugs, in stores now.
So they're talking about how it overheats, and then he's all like, I hope your parents don't die in a fire. Insane. Insane. All right, I'm gonna save and quite. Yeah, I'm gonna call it a night. What time is it? Yeah, it's like 10 o'clock here. I'm gonna call it a night. Oh my god, I love one of those preview. Ooh. Hold on. Oh, cool. Challenge room. Interfearful. Bozeman has taken away the cable to the satellite to save money, and because he thought it might be a snake. Now we've got interference all over the shop, and it's coming faster than ever. Switcheroo, the aftermath of Dave and Frank's prank war. Frank's the head of maintenance, and Dave's an irritating prick. Frank messed with Dave's vision mixer buttons, and now they switch which screen they are attached to without warning. Oh, no. It's fair play, though, after what Dave did to the water cooler. Or custom. What is shocking development? Can I see what it is? I wanna... Can I... Why can't I turn it on? I want to see what it is! Rewards? Oh, there's stuff. Well. Alright. Well. I'm going to call her a night, because I am getting a little drunk on my third beer, so... And I'm going to... I got some Bones to watch, okay? I'm on, like, season 9. I gotta... Well, it's not like I haven't seen the rest before, but... I'm on season 9 of this watch-through. I'm excited. I'm getting there. Live and Spooky. Coming March 23rd. Wishlist now. That looks creepy. Gosh darn. Maybe I'll have to play through a lot of this before I get to that. Anywho. Sorry, I'm still watching, like, the... main screen, and it keeps showing clips that are hilarious on the little TV there. So I'm gonna stop looking at it. Anyways, next stream should be playing Death and Taxes and The Wandering Village. So I will give warning on that one so that everyone can be available to be in the chat, because they are chat games. It'll probably be on Sunday. guessing from how my week appointments are laid out, I am going to guess that Sunday will be the day, but it might happen before then. But I'll try to announce Sunday as the day, and then if it's going to happen before, I'll try to give enough time for people to be able to be there. But either way, I'm probably still going to do it Sunday. Anyways. If you're on YouTube watching this in the future, subscribe, hit that subscribe button, smash that bell, abuse that like button, tickle that, join. I don't think you can join. I think you have to have, I don't think I have subscribers on YouTube. snuggle right up to that, friend button, jingle the balls of that like notification. I don't fucking know what else there is. Anyways. Hit me up. All my socials are Socks with Pockets in some kind of format, whether it be Socks dot with dot pockets or Socks with Pockets with spaces or Socks with Pockets with underscores. Find me and follow me so I can do, especially on TikTok, so I can go live because I'm only like 200 followers away from being able to go live on there. So, anywhoozle, I will, oh, right, I'm using the wrong mouse. Anywhoozle. I muted you. What am I hearing? Anyways, I love y'all. Ooh. God damn. Y'all are the best. See that? Like, it looks like a heart from my side, but doesn't from your side. Why did we like that? We're a very selfish generation, apparently, because we made it just for us and not at all for... That sucks. This one's much better. And these little tiny hearts. All right. Anyways, love you guys. I will see you next.